So I want to teach you again how to control Newcastle, or how to prevent Newcastle. So I told you this is one of the main challenges again in the industry. Number one being the disease coccidia, and also number two, Newcastle disease. This is a virus disease. So you cannot treat it once it comes. You can only prevent it. So prevention is better than cure. So for control of Newcastle, you vaccinate the bird at different stages. Are we together? So there are two types of vaccines. We have the oral vaccine, for example. So this is an oral vaccine. Are we together? This one is an oral vaccine. So it means that for us to give the birds this vaccine, you have to mix it with water. Are we together? So before you give the bird this vaccine, you don't just take it, then break the cover and you put in water and you open the lid, then you mix with the water. No. You have to break this lid and open the cover from inside the water. Are we together? So when you're vaccinating the chicken against Newcastle, you're doing it orally, that is using this vaccine, there are certain procedures that you have to follow. Number one, you strictly have to use water that is not chlorinated, that has no high amount of chlorine. Are you together? Because high amount of chlorine will then make the vaccine not function very efficiently. So what do you do? You either have to use rain water, or you boil water, or you use some elements that can be used to reduce the amount of chlorine in the water. Are we together? Before you administer the vaccine. This vaccine should not be stored under normal temperatures, that is between 21 degrees Celsius and above, for a long time, period of time. If you're preserving this vaccine, you should refrigerate it. Understand, do not freeze. Don't put it in the freezer. You refrigerate it. Are you together? Because this is a live virulent vaccine. It's an attenuated vaccine. You understand when I say attenuated vaccine? It's just the virus, but it has been suppressed. And you understand? So the frequency of doing this vaccine, if you're using the oral vaccine, you do it depending on the frequency of occurrence of the disease at your place. Are you together? So for example, here we have a very high frequency of the disease reoccurring. So we need to do this vaccine almost after every 2 months, sometimes even after a month, we re-give it. But instead of doing this oral vaccine repeatedly and repeatedly, you then use a very nice vaccine that is 6 months old. It has a duration of 6 months. Once you vaccinate the bird, it will go for 6 months or 1 year. Are you together? So that is the vaccine now that is called the Lasota injectable. So you can open our cooler box. Just open. Give me that vaccine, then return this one here. So this is the vaccine. The ITER new Newcastle disease vaccine. Are you together? This one is manufactured by a company called Laprovet. This is the best vaccine. I'm telling you from experience. This vaccine, once you inject the chicken, it's guaranteed. 6 months, you'll never see any sign of Newcastle. Sometimes it can go even for a year. And mostly it's used by breeders. So as long as you bought the vaccine that has not expired, and you have handled it well, you have not put it in the freezer, you have refrigerated it, then you come to use it and you inject your birds with the required personnel, or you have the experience. So then, how do you do it? Let's go. You will take the vaccine. It depends on if you are using, you can either use the normal syringe, the normal injection, or you can use this automatic injection. Are you together? So if you're using an automatic injection, this is the procedure. So this is the procedure. Get me the long needle, the needle. So you will take the needle, all right? Then you will press it onto the vaccine like that. Are you together? Then you will take your vaccination gun and you will connect it here. Up like that, right? You will take a small needle, okay? And then you'll perforate up on the vaccine like that. This is to make it not to be airlock. Are we together? Then you will take a needle that has not been used by any other person or for any other work, and then you will tie it at the head, at the tip of the gun, like that. Are you together? So you have it connected together, and then you will remove like that. Are you together? Then you test to see if it's working. So you set up your gun. For this vaccine of Laprovet, the ITAN Newcastle, it is strictly, you have to read the dosage. So it is 0.5 ml per bud. We have set our vaccination gun to 0.5 ml. Are you together? So every dose is 0.5. Then you suck. So we can suck. You can see the vaccine is coming through the pipe. So it's coming like that. Like that. Until it gets to the, you'll see it getting to the gun. Make sure that you don't spill the vaccine on the floor, because it will spread to other parts of the farm. Are you together? So then, how do you inject the bud? Where do you inject the bud? You can give us, you can come with this cock, just stand up. Sorry. All right. So you can come, you can hold the vaccine for us, the bottle for us, make sure it's bent like that, yeah? So you can come and see, you can just stand. So make sure you don't cover the camera, all right? So stand like this. So make sure, if you are doing the injection, make sure you're doing the vaccine. Two people, one person holds for you the bud, and then you inject. Are you together? So when injecting this vaccine, you can do the injection at two places. Are we together? You can either inject on the thigh. Are we together? This is the thigh on the meat. All right? So you get back to your vaccine and then you read the injection, the instructions, so that you can know whether it is subcutaneous, intramuscular, or it's IV. But this one is mostly subcutaneous. You can do it subcutaneous or you can do it intramuscular. Are you together? So when you inject the bud, personally, I usually recommend you do it on the thigh. Are you together? You don't inject the bud deep to the bone. You should, the tip of the needle should never touch the bone. Are you together? So you inject the bud at least at 60 degrees. 60 degrees. You see the angle between my, the angle between the leg and the needle is 60 degrees. Are you together? You don't do it at 90 degrees. You're likely to injure the bud. Are you together? So this is the point. You get some muscle. You see, like that. Then you can do your injection like that, soft like that. Then you press. Are you together? So you are done. The bird does not complain. He's happy. So you can stretch him. He's a happy one. All right? So number two, you can also do this vaccine on the breast. Are you together? So we can, so this is John. We vaccinated him on the thigh. So you can bring Kevin. Bring Kevin over. It's your turn. Make sure that the person who is holding for you the bird holds the two legs firmly. Are we together? Then, using your left hand, you hold the bird from this, from the shoulders. Just leave it. You hold the bird from the shoulders. Are you together? Then feel the where there is the breast. Are you together? So here is our breast. Are you together? Get where it is fleshy for you to do the intramuscular injection. Then you simply inject just a few millimeters and then you press. You can do like 5 to 8 millimeters. Are you together? So we have injected Kevin. Are we together? So I want Sabrine to inject for us the last bird. Can kindly have it so that we know if you've gotten the lesson or not. All right, so I'll come the other side. So you will do the injection, just bring the bird. Which bird is it? Is this one? You can bring it. Yeah, you can hold it. Please, when you're touching the bird, turn it slowly. Make sure you don't injure, you don't break the legs, all right? You turn it slowly, like that. So you hold the bird, this, let me just show you. Just leave it. Always hold the bird in this direction. Just hold the legs together, and then you hold for her, like that. Are you together? So that you feel the bird, then inject. All right, can vaccinate. Good. That's it. Clap for yourselves. Our class is finished. Thank you. So you subscribe to the channel and videos are going to come. We shall learn in our next video, we should be able to learn on how to do the fowlpox vaccine. Are you okay now? Thank you. He's free. Now he's feeling good. He can go.